Welcome back to Tech Mimic, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. The topic of this video is QEMU, but I believe that QMU is the most widely accepted pronunciation. I'm going to cover how to install QMU KVM step by step on Fedora 40, and how to spin up your first virtual machine with some tips and tricks along the way, and a general explanation of the Virtual Machine Manager software that you would use to manage your virtual machines. If you have ever used VirtualBox or VMware, this will look very familiar to you. If not, don't worry, it is easy to understand. There's also a specific video for Linux Mint and Ubuntu, if that is of interest to you. A link is in the description below for your convenience. KVM stands for Kernel-Based Virtual Machine, and it is available by default on Linux, as it is built into the kernel since 2007. I'm going to assume your version is a current one, and also the machine you are using for this is not older than, let's say, 7 to 8 years. In that case, most likely virtualization settings are already enabled in your system's BIOS or UEFI and active in your operating system. To test this, open a terminal and type the command egrep-c quote open parentheses vmx pipe svm close parentheses quote space /proc/cpu-info. The returned value should be greater than 0. If it is 0, go into your BIOS or UEFI and enable virtualization technology. This will be different for every machine, so you would have to do some research if needed. A second alternative could be to type the command lscpu pipe grep virtualization, yes, with a capital V and a Z. This should return VT-X for Intel-based systems and AMD-V for AMD-based systems. And the third alternative I will show you shortly. Now we need to install some packages. Type the command sudo dnf install qemu-kvm libvirt-daemon libvirt-client and vert-manager. Add the user that you would like to run the virtual machines with to the group KVM. Type sudo usermod-a-G-KVM and then your username. Now reboot the machine. A third method to validate if your machine is ready for virtualization is by using the virt host validate command that was installed as part of the libvirt client packets. Type the command sudo virt-host-validate qemu pipe grep virtualization. The result should read pass. After the reboot, we need to enable and start the library virtualization daemon. Type sudo systemctl enable --now libvirtd and sudo systemctl start libvirtd. Check if the library virtualization daemon is up and running with the command sudo systemctl status libvirtd. The libvirtd service is run. We can now start to use Virtual Machine Manager. But before we do, let me show you this useful command line utility named vir-sh, the Virtualization Interactive Terminal. Start with the command vir-sh. The command list will show all of your configured virtual machines. But of course, at this point, there are none. Just type help to see the many available options. You can manage all things virtual machines from this terminal. For the remainder of this video, we will use the Virtual Machine Manager software, but I wanted to let you know about the Virtualization Interactive Terminal. Type quit to exit. Now open the menu and select Virtual Machine Manager. Let's add VMM to the panel for easy access. Virtual Machine Manager provides a user-friendly graphical interface for creating and managing your virtual machines. Because there is no difference in the interface of Virtual Machine Manager between Linux Mint, Ubuntu, or Fedora, instead of recycling the same video, from this point forward, now that everything is installed, I would like to suggest to you continue watching the video How to Configure QEMU KVM Hypervisor and Run a Virtual Machine in Linux Mint and Ubuntu. A link is in the description of this video and at the end of this video. Pick up at the part of the video where the configuration of the first virtual machine starts. As stated before, the interface will be exactly the same, so ignore the fact that that video is for Linux Mint or Ubuntu. It will just work well on Fedora. That's it. Hope it helped. And if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time. Bye.